2 months ago, Google released their AI app builder, Firebase Studio, and we compared it with Bolt. Let's see where it holds up 2 months later. We're going to build a very simple app that generates date night ideas. So what you do is visit studio.firebase.google.com and type in your prompt in the prompt box. And here we have an app that generates date night ideas, and hit prototype with AI. What Firebase Studio does initially is generate a plan. This is within less than a minute, it's generated a plan. So here is generating features. I haven't given it no features in my prompt. So it's generating ideas for features. It has idea generation here, preference input here, idea display. You can save ideas, share ideas, and it's created style guidelines for us. And it has suggested a stack. So we have Gemini. Let's just select here. So yep, it has Gemini. And for the UI, it's using Tailwind CSS, TypeScript, Next.js. So we're going to hit prototype this app. Firebase Studio is now finished with our date night generator. I believe it hasn't automatically generated a Gemini key. And this is a part of the beautiful thing of being within the Google ecosystem. I believe we can just hit auto-generate and it's going to auto-generate us a key for Gemini. It now says the first iteration of our app prototype is ready. So let's select a budget. Let's select a preferred cuisine. I don't know, chicken. Let's select a location. Let's just leave nearby and see what it does. I'm not sure if it'll pick up my current location. And let's select an activity. Let's say intellectual. And here, generate date night ideas. So it's using Gemini here and my preferences to generate date night ideas. It's a attend a chicken themed cooking class. Okay, that's interesting. Visit a local poultry farm and learn about the different chicken breeds, followed by a homemade chicken dinner. I think that's a definitely interesting date night idea. Solve a murder mystery dinner with a chicken based menu. Okay, lots of really interesting ideas. But it's taking our preferences and using Gemini to generate date night ideas. We can see here that it does have a slight UI error. So let's just see if it's... I think the UI error was only because of like the size of the window or the size of the frame. It says save here, but it shouldn't be able to save because we haven't created user profiles or any way for users to sign in or sign up. To do that, I believe we would have to connect Superbase or Firebase would make the most sense. But it's not immediately clear here if you don't even know what Firebase is. It would be great if it could suggest, hey, to be able to add user profiles, maybe you should integrate Firebase. So let's just see what happens if I click save. Okay, it breaks when I click save. We're going to go back. And it seems now it's broken, so I'm going to have to say fix this error. Now, Firebase Studio has fixed the error, and it seemed it did actually save a date night idea. And I'm not quite sure how it's doing this, so I'm just going to ask. I'm going to ask it, how does the save feature work? Well, Firebase Studio has said that it's saving it in the browser's local storage, which is amazing, which is great. It means users don't actually have to sign in, which is amazing. That's what we want. We're going to test this enhanced feature and see what it actually does by enhancing a date night idea. Again, remember it's using Gemini to do this. So what it does, which is super cool, it enhances the details and it looks like it's giving a more detailed view on how the date should go. And lastly, let's see what share does. And it raised another issue. This is why it's super important to test all the buttons and features that any of the AI app builders really generate. So we're going to go into this issue and try to fix this issue. Firebase Studio is now finished with those fixes. So let's click share again. And it copied to the clipboard. So I'm not quite sure in copying to the clipboard what it actually did. So let's just, okay. It just copied the date night idea, copied the text of the date night idea to the clipboard, which is cool. I'm going to ask it, how can I improve this app? A challenge that I have encountered is that I asked for ideas on how to improve it, and it automatically got to coding. You have to say, don't write any code, and then you can just kind of have a conversation. They don't have a chat feature yet. Some of the other AI app builders have a chat feature. So it seems that it did give ideas, but it also did write code and make code changes. So let's just see what code changes it actually made. So it made some code changes to add an image or an image placeholder. You can see try indoor rock climbing for fun. That's amazing. That's great. So there are a couple challenges. So I do actually like it adding image placeholders. Some of the other platforms just use AI to generate images, which kind of, and it's using AI to generate new images every time. So let's say you saved it, like we have one somewhere saved. It will, every time you revisit, it will generate a new image for that saved item or that saved piece of data. You don't want to do that. I like that it's producing placeholders here for now. We would have to tell it, hey, like source images from somewhere or add images from somewhere. We want an image associated to this. Not quite sure how it would do that. We could give it the challenge and give it ways and let it suggest ways for us to actually solve it. Also, we have location here and it says nearby, but it doesn't actually know where I am. It's not using the location feature. So I would have to tell it, use my actual location and suggest actual things near me. Let's give that a try. So we're going to try to tell it to use my actual location and suggest things near me that are within my preferred cuisine, my budget, and the type of activity. To do that, it actually has to use the internet. So let's see if Firebase Studio can work out to do this effectively. It has to use the internet. Now that it's finished, we're going to try again. So we're going to put any budget, leave it at any cuisine. We still have nearby. And this is just text. So it doesn't actually know where nearby is. Let's just say London. Let's say cultural and generate date night ideas. And again, it's using its knowledge base. So it knows the British Museum. It knows the Shakespeare's Globe. It knows the Tate Modern. These are very, very obvious things. If there was a new location that popped up last week or a new type of event that popped up recently after its training data, it wouldn't actually be able to pick it up because it's not using no web search or agentic functionality. All in all, I think Firebase Studio for a use case like this is super easy to use. Really great to go in a couple of minutes. And we're going to switch to the code just to see what the code looks like. You can adapt the code, you can review the code, you can make changes at the code level. What we're going to do is publish and to see how this is when we publish it. And it is publishing to Firebase, so it's automatically connected to Firebase. Now, it says the app hosting is a pay-as-you-go service. And you need to create a cloud billing account and go through your whole Google Cloud process. That might be a potential bottleneck. It's definitely a bottleneck for me. A lot of the other platforms are super simple to go through it and publish. The cloud billing process and creating a cloud billing account has never really been the most straightforward process to me, especially once you get into Google Cloud Platform. It can get a little confusing. We've clicked to set up a cloud billing account. We are going to set up our currency. We are going to leave this at that with our card on account. And it's saying about a payment. Now I have to go and verify. So I've created a Google Cloud billing account. And it seems it is linked. So we need to click link and we'll enable Firebase services. So this is now being hosted on Firebase, which is Google's hosting platform. And we can hit publish now. I think the great advantage here is Google has everything in-house. They have hosting, they have domains. They now have Firebase Studio where you can build the applications. You can do marketing with Google. You can basically stay within the Google ecosystem if you wanted to, which is a huge bonus. Firebase Studio is now ready, so we can view our app at this domain. And now we have our app. If we give it a test, it's generating app ideas. And we can see our ideas have been generated. It seems in comparison to London that it hasn't provided specific locations like the Tate Modern or anything very, very specific. However, we have gone from idea to publish application in minutes without coding. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out the link in the description to go to No Code MBA, a learning platform with dozens of in-depth, high-quality courses on no code and AI taught by industry experts. And be sure to subscribe to our channel here to get more free content on YouTube. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next video.